to reestablish the sign committee to full committee status and recommend that the ordinance amendments be forwarded to City Council for adoption.
Thank you. Mr. Lamon.
Good afternoon. I'll be doing most of the report today. I'm also accompanied by Susan Gantz, one of our staff members who deals with all the sign applications currently. Today's purpose of meeting is to consider our recommendation to reestablish the sign committee and to review draft ordinance amendments to the sign regulations in order to accomplish that. We are recommending these ordinance amendments be forwarded to council for adoption. As outlined in the staff report, in 2009, there was an economic downturn in the economy, and staff was asked to consider different reductions, which would lead to better workload efficiencies, because we realized that there would be staff reductions. We'd have to operate differently. So one suggestion that we worked with a subcommittee of design review board members was to consider adjusting the sign review processing to reduce the sign committee and create two separate consent reviews. The ability to do that allowed us to staff one less full committee and therefore allow for a different type of review process for sign applications. The change was supported at the time by the sign committee, but it was understood that it was on a temporary basis, and eventually that action was approved by council in 2010. So why are we proposing the change now? Well, the sign committee has waited patiently for the economy to rebound and have also made several requests to asking staff when we could reestablish the sign committee. Now, it seemed logical when we increased staff back again to a certain level. I actually had an initial planning tech added to my section, that it seemed an appropriate manner to incorporate these additional reestablishment of sign committee duties. Currently, there are two separate reviews by the ABR and HLC for the sign applications. You'll see I have a flow chart that explains that dual consent review. Right now, those reviews happen independently of one another. So there's actually two sign committee reviews happening. And we believe that that doesn't allow for the desired consistency in sign application reviews. And that's critical because business owners want to know that they've been treated fairly, that they're getting the same type of treatment consistently with respect to the amount of signage they're proposing and the type of signs that are approved. The proposed sign committee is slightly different, and rather than return it back to a five-member sign committee size, we're suggesting that three members would be adequate. And the reason we're doing that is we're having a challenge right now with recruitment of sufficient citizen volunteers. We have actually vacancies on all our review boards at this current time. And so we are realistic that rather than try to accomplish a larger recruitment period of membership, that it would be a gradual maybe increase. Start off with the three-member consistent one review sign committee, and then leading towards an eventual increase if it was warranted. One of the other aspects that's different this time is we are actually proposing that the two current assigned members from the ABR and the HLC operate only as alternates. Right now, they're actually appointed by the individual body and are expected to attend these meetings. It's a tremendous time allocation and commitment right now to these board members. We're actually having a struggle getting board members to attend these sign committee meetings because often it's at the on the same day of their full commitment. It's either on a Wednesday where the HLC meets, they would arrive early that day to deal with the sign committee duties. And some of these members are also serving on the consent calendar. So we're finding that that commitment level is not there as is in the past. The ABR has the same capacity problems right now because they're undermanned right now. We actually have some items that are continued because lack of a quorum, because we only have six members. So again, that challenge of getting them to also commit to the sign committee for reviews is something that we think is not sustainable. And that's why we're recommending a three-member size. So that what that involves now is we've worked with our city clerk to try to open up a recruitment currently in the mid-year timeframe to allow that one additional member to be added. And I'll sort of explain to you that size difference in a flowchart. Again, three at-large members would reduce the time commitment, and the two appointed alternates would, again, serve only when needed. The composition still would require two members to possess some type of professional experience. We feel that it's important that we have some design professionals involved that have some experience dealing with where signs are located on buildings and having some knowledge, because some signs actually involve structural information, details, and also electrical installations when they are proposed to be lit. We are proposing one member be an at-large that preferably has some business owner and real estate professional experience. I think that would help balance out the dynamics that happen with sign applications. I think to get a perspective that business owners have to try to actually give their perspective in the input on what is a reasonable amount of signage. Again, the one alternate from each ABR and HLC are as proposed, again, only on an as-needed backup basis. Now, what are the expected impacts? We actually will result in one less meeting per week. Because we combine two consent calendars, we will have only one meeting biweekly. It allows more time for the ABR and HL workload to be shared by the board members because of the increased activity, and therefore they won't have this commitment. And the existing planning administrative can support the full-time work of the sign committee. We believe that they can work that in. Will improve efficiencies and have a positive effect for sign applicants and customers. We really believe that if they feel that they're being treated fairly, consistently, that is a better overall experience. And we believe that there will be no significant expenditures that will be required in order to implement this change. We do expect to update our sign review guidelines to reflect this revised sign application review process. And our proposed meeting time will again return back to a morning AM Tuesday morning meeting to be the joint full sign committee time frame. So at this time, we would like this temporary abbreviated sign review process to be changed. It's worked as expected for 6 years. It was intended as an interim solution. And at this point, planning staff supports the sign committee's members' request to reestablish the sign committee. Now, what I'm going to do is also show you the current review process. The way it's explained here is that you actually have two review processes that can occur. You can have an application that gets routed to the HLC for conforming. It's a quick, every week, Natalie Cope or Bob Cunningham, our current sign committee review members, can review simple sign applications. It works fine. But then if a project is more complex, it's referred either to a two-member consent review or a two-member ABR review. They work independent. And they all are staffed either by ABR HLC members in order to get a two-member quorum. Now, a two-member quorum requires you to agree. You have to get a consensus, and that doesn't always work to get two members. We believe a three-member odd number would be the preferred alternative. Now, this is what's proposed now is to combine those two consent reviews to one sign committee review, have three members, and then the ABR HLC members would only be filling in down here as alternates if when needed. And we believe that's a much more sustainable approach to not have them commit to every meeting, but also be available if we need them. Now, you understand that the process is also that the HLC full commission and ABR full board are still involved with an appeal process. If for some reason the sign committee's decision is not found acceptable, an applicant can appeal directly to those larger boards and still get the ABR and the HLC to make weigh in before it comes to council. So I thought that was important to show you that this, in fact, is the structural change that will occur as proposed. Do you have any questions on that?
Ms. Bringer, no?
Thank you. So what you just said at the end, that's the appeal process. If the applicant isn't happy with the sign committee's final ruling, it would be appealed to one of those two.
That's correct. There's an interim appeal process before it gets to council.
And so you're recruiting during this, we have an open recruitment period right now.
Yes, the city clerk agreed to contingent on this council direction that we could in fact recruit and then appoint if we go forward to council and actually create the position. And we expect to move forward quickly if you agree with today's recommendation.
So what would you respond to someone who's concerned about three members instead of five being such a concentration of power where three people would be making the decision instead of five. But I guess it's been functioning with two, and I haven't heard any complaints. But what would be your response, Mr. Lamone?
Councilmember Marino, I believe it's always a challenge to get a majority, whether it's three, five, or seven. So you have more input that involves different various opinions. But I also believe that if they all review the same application in an equal manner, there's no inconsistency with what is the norm. And therefore, you have three members consistently reviewing the same type of applications, and there would be a tendency to be more equal and fair. I see sometimes some inconsistencies in what some businesses get as far as signage and what size of signage they get. And I think it involves personal opinions that sometimes come out strongly, saying they feel that this is consistent with what they've allowed in the past. So we believe a three-member will easily have a two-member consensus, because only two need to be a majority to have an application move forward.
Okay, and as I said, I don't get complaints. I get lots of complaints, but nothing about that. So, but do you get complaints, Mr. Lamone, from applicants who are saying?
I do see some inconsistencies that are questioned as far as why a business isn't given more signage. Because if you understand the allowable signage standards, one could propose something that they believe is allowable, like 1 square foot per lineal foot of frontage is the allowable square footage. But often it's a subjective nature as to whether or not that is an acceptable amount of signage. So let's say you have a 30-foot lineal foot of frontage, and somebody says, well, I'm going to propose 30 square feet because that's what's allowable. Yet when they propose that 30-square-foot sign, it's often out of scale with what's been approved in adjacent businesses. So from a fairness standpoint, they reduce the signage to something more consistent with that block face. So there is some challenges there about how much signage someone should be entitled to.
Okay. And so you're recruiting for one person more.
Yes.
Because you have the two.
Yes.
Okay. So when I was first reading this, I was hoping it would be someone from the sign making community, not because there's different businesses around town. I happen to have a friend that works at one of them. But you said real estate or business, so.
Well, we're trying to go back in time. And I remember that we had at-large members that came sometimes from the business communities to sort of balance what the predominance were. They were design professionals on the board. And we thought that was a good mix. Now, sign makers, I mean, they essentially have a conflict because sometimes they're producing the signs in the community. We think it deserves some type of additional at-large position. You could disagree with that type of professional. You could leave it open at-large and see who comes forward in the community that's interested.
Well, I'm just saying that everyone has not an agenda, but everyone comes with their bias. And so if you have someone on the sign committee now who wants everything to be in Padre Brown and it has to be a certain size, then they're coming with a bias that might be balanced out by someone who tries to make signs and put them up in the city. So,
I just wanted to like to comment one more time, Ms. Murillo, that the inconsistency also comes from individual ABR members that don't consistently come to each meeting. Sometimes we recruit different members and they have not had a history in consistently reviewing sign applications. So sometimes they come off base with the type of comments that are not normally made. Now, what's been nice about the city's process is we've had Natalie Cope and Bob Cunningham be actually members multi-terms.
Okay.
Their commitment to continue that process may not continue. So we need to get some new blood in here to get somebody with experience to continue that, because we're not guaranteed that they will continue to be committed to additional terms.
Okay, and I'm sorry, I've gone over into deliberations a little bit, Mr. Chair, but so then it's up to the city council, right, to appoint the right person and then to keep an eye on things if adjustments need to be made, if depending on who right? If the new way that we're going back to isn't quite working, right, you're going to keep an eye on that, or one of your staff?
Definitely. We will definitely monitor it. I mean, we've already monitored it in a sense that in order to efficiently review applications, more and more applicants were being placed on conforming. That's the reality. And conforming is a one-week turnaround. One person reviewing each sign based on location in the city.
Wow.
We don't think that's the it might be efficient and quick for applications to be approved, but it doesn't give consistency because both conforming reviewers aren't talking to one another as far as what they're accepting.
Okay. And then finally, those two diagrams were not in our packet.
Right.
You would put them on the city website?
We can add them. Yeah, I thought it would be helpful to help you understand what the
very
difference
helpful.
Is. And I apologize we didn't include that.
That's okay. Thank you, Mr. Limon. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
So that I understand the graph itself or the process as it exists and as proposed in the intake process for the project. So with Ms. Cope or Mr. Cunningham on either side of this, is that they're at the counter? Can they actually issue a final decision at that point in time without it coming to the full? Or they just continue back?
Councilmember Rouse, there's no such thing as an over-the-counter review, but it's often within a day or two. They have a standard time within the week where they review applications. It could be a Tuesday or Wednesday morning. They sit down with staff, Ms. Gans, and go over each application that we believe qualifies under conforming review and get direction back immediately to the applicant as to whether they're acceptable or whether the project is referred to the consent calendar. If it's unacceptable, then there's more eyes placed on these applications.
So it could then go to consent.
It could get bumped up, yes.
Okay, but just trying to, you know, sometimes the process seems capricious to certain
right.
applicants, and so.
Right.
And then
if I add, Mr. Rouse, we will maintain the conforming review process still. That
right.
still exists. I'm just more concerned about what happens when we don't have that commitment to come in on a weekly basis as a volunteer.
No, and I certainly understand the recruitment process and how difficult it is these days. But lastly, anecdotally, what I get complaints about is actually about enforcement from those who've had to comply in the past, and then they see other things exist, and they go, why is that guy getting that, and
right.
I got this. Well, this process, this isn't about that, I understand.
Right.
But is that going to have a tie-in to more consistent enforcement as far as you can see?
Councilman Rouse, we believe that an active sign committee has a better monitoring system for staff to be on top of illegal signs. They will point things out that they are aware were not approved through their sign committee and have a more consistent recognition that which signs are out there illegally. And therefore, we'll have a quicker response. So we hope to have an improved process.
Very good.
Ready to make
a move. We want to hear some public comment today.
Oh, public comment.
Thank you.
Oh, did we have a... you just... If Mr. House, if you would... mention your name for the record, we'd appreciate that.
Yes, I am Steve House, and I strongly support this... this change. I think the thing that I feel most strongly about is I would strongly urge you to consider 5 members. As you may know, I served 8 years on the ABR and I served 8 years on the HLC. And for most of the time on both of those tenures, I was liaison to sign committee. I, besides being an architect, have a background in graphic design. I think that being an alternate that replaces one of the 3 on the sign committee, they're coming into a meeting not having any background of what's been reviewed at an earlier meeting, and usually not a lot of expertise in the fields of signs. I mean, it's quite different than just straight architecture. So, and also I feel that being liaison to sign committee is just another committee assignment, and we do have committee assignments being on those larger bodies. I just don't see it as that much of an added burden, and I think the benefit of having 5 outweighs anything else. Well, I don't think I'll touch on anything else. Jaime has spoken to enforcement, and that's a very important thing, because I think the best way to be business friendly is to have a level playing field, and everybody knows that enforcement is happening, and everybody needs to get a permit, and so I'm happy to see all that happening. Thank you.
Thank you for your comment. Ms. Murillo?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. So, Mr. Lamone, to respond to the speaker, we've already talked about monitoring, right? If we go with three members, and I guess that would be one of the things to look out for, was would we need to go to five? And then the question that he raised for me was, when someone's on the committee, the new person, and then the alternates, do they get a training session, an orientation session related to what it means to review signage?
Councilmember Maria, I think it's a valid concern. I mean, if you don't do it on a week biweekly basis, you aren't as familiar with all the guidelines that are existing. The balance that we have to go forward with a recognition is, yes, there are more time commitments made now to our advisory board members. I've seen it grow. We have subcommittees that get created monthly. And in respect to Mr. Haas was a great citizen volunteer, that commitment to come to these meetings. Last night, there was an ABR meeting that lasted to 9 o'clock. And if they had had a sign committee at 2 o'clock, that's a long day for someone. And so what we're doing is being realistic and saying, maybe we're putting too much strain on our existing ABR HLC liaisons right now. And I'd rather have them work on a part-time periodic basis and train them and get them up to speed than trying to get that commitment too often. And so obviously, if you want five members, that could be direction to further expand later this year, at the end of the year. But right now, we only have one vacancy that we posted for. And so we couldn't fill it mid-year. We could have to challenge ourselves to find two board members in December.
Well, Mr. Chair, certainly whoever turns out to be the city council liaison to that advisory group should take it seriously, what the speaker said, and also how it's working, right? And I guess I've heard this ever since I've been on the council, the sign committee, and so here it is. And I do support it. And with all due respect, Mr. Howes, I will recommend the staff. I will move the staff recommendation of three members and put this to the, move it to the city council. Thank
you. And I'll second that. So you'll have a 2-aye and 1 absent. We'll move it forward to the council.
Okay.
Thank you very much. And thank you, Mr. Howes, for coming in and checking in with us. Sure. We are adjourned.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming, Steve.